animals, all combination that we are considering, and which cup is used for them. If the cup is used, we place a 1. If not, we place a 0. So for x1 and x2 is used p1, q1, q2. So that's what the RSES does. The first thing it's going to do, so when you run the RAL set exploration system to do discretization, the first thing it's going to do is a binary table. If the cup is used, it's a 1. If the cup is not used, it's a 0. The second step that it will do is choose the column with maximum number of 1s. If we do this for our table, we will end up with 3 columns left, which would be P2, P4, and Q2. And these are considered the optimal cuts for deciding the number of intervals that we need to have for that particular data set. So according to this algorithm in RSES, because we said we need to make a decision how many categories they have and which ones they're going to be. According to this algorithm, if we run this, we will end up using 3 cuts, and so we're going to create 4 intervals. So for attribute A, it will be cut into 2 pieces by this P2. So from beginning of A until 115, and from 1 for A, So from 115 to 1.5. I'm sorry, for A we have two of them, P2 and P4. So the first one will be from beginning to 115, the second one will be from 115 to 1.5. And for B we have one, which is Q2. For B from to 1.5. From beginning of B to 1.5. And from 1.5 to the end of B. So essentially what this did is, after we compute this cuts for all the objects that differ on the decision attribute, we need to create a discernibility formula. And the way we create this formula is by taking conjunctive normal form of all of these. And we are using the idea of gradients here because we're talking about RSES and it uses reduct. So then remember the reduct was the smallest subset of a particular set. Well, there is no smaller subset. And if any set is more general than the other sets, then we can keep the more general set because it includes the less general ones, then we can just cross them out the way we did in layers and the way we did in the formula when we were looking for redux. Or we're doing the same thing here. After we write this formula, what we can do is, like, look at this one for example, P2 and Q1, P2 or Q1, so the plus is the or, the asterisk is the and. So this set P2 or Q1. As we can see over here, we have the set being P2 or Q1 with a bunch of other stuff added to it. Well, this is more specific. This is more general. This one includes all of that stuff. And so we can cross it out and just leave this one. And so after we cross out some of them, we would eventually simplify the formula and end up with something like this. So let's do an example.